day everyone, today we're gonna talk about the PM335 device from the SATEC company. The SATEC PRO meters are compact multifunctional three-phase power meter designed to meet the needs of users ranging from the panel builders to substation operators. The equipment consists from the graphic display. It also have watt hour and kilowatt hour pulse LED, navigation buttons, also loads bar graph, ERCOM port, and also we have here the USB Type-C port. How switch it on? If we are using an AC power supply, we must connect the line wire to terminal L plus and the neutral wire to terminal N minus. If we use DC power supply, we need to connect the positive wire to terminal L plus and the negative wire to terminal N minus. PRO allows the measurement of 1 from 1 to 4 independent DC sources via 3 independent DC voltage inputs. When the PRO is used as a single DC meter, V1 and I1 must be used. V2 and V3 must be connected to the ground. When the PRO unit is used as a multi-channel DC meter, V1, I1, V2, I2, etc. are used as the independent channels. The SATEC PRO meters measures up to 800 volts DC by direct connection to the PRO meter. It can also measure from 1500 volts DC to 2500 volts DC systems via the SATEC voltage ratio model, VRM. When using the VRM, it's recommended that the distance between this model and the SATEC meter doesn't exceed 2 meters using wiring with a minimum of 600 volt insulation. PRO meters have 4 independent current inputs with a nominal current of 20 mA to which the user can connect standard Hall effect sensors with 0 to 20 mA or plus minus 20 mA outputs. Power supply requirements for Hall sensors are double insulation, it's no air connection allowed, surge with stand of 3 kV or more, and SATEC each EPS Hall effect sensor power supply can be plus minus 15 volt DC, or it may be 20 volt DC power supply. It's depending on Hall sensor effect type. Communication with PRO meters can be established independently and simultaneously through each communication port using the supporting pass program supplied with the device or the user application software. All communication ports are slave ports and have factory preset parameters such as baud rate, data format, and communication protocol, which can be easily changed if required. As I mentioned before, the device also have the RS-485 interface, 2 independent Ethernet ports, and ear port. Here we have the USB Type-C port. A USB node port is for local communication with the supporting pass software. It's connected directly to the USB port of your PC using the supplied USB cable. No settings are required for USB communication. Simply connect your PC to the PRO meter's USB port and install the supplied USB driver. USB communication is 10 times faster than serial communication at the maximum baud rate. Let's talk about the Ethernet ports. These Ethernet ports allow the PRO meter to be directly connected to a local area network using the TCP/IP protocols. No device identification is required when connecting via the Ethernet ports. The SATEC PRO meters respond to any device address and return the received address in the response message. The two Ethernet ports can either be configured for a separate and independent Ethernet port or used for daisy chain configuration. Ports about the display. Here we have the favorite button. It displays predefined favorite screens. We have the escape menu button. It go one menu level up until the main menu screen. It exit screen without descending any value, exit field editing without the saving, and so on. Also, here we have the up and down buttons that go up and down over the menu items, that ignoring the level, scrolling the fields. It can also help us for navigating up and down or right left. It also can increment and decrement any counters and so on. And also here we have the OK or Enter button. It open next level up. It opens a corresponding display screen. It enters field editing screen. It also have the saves and sends value. It close fields editing screen. And by using this button, we can go to the parent configuration screen. And also, it can help us to enable favorite screens. As I mentioned before, it's the first button. So, the Pro devices has six multi-page displays. The first one display predefined favorite screens. The monitor displays all electrical parameters value. It can be the voltage, can be the current, power, and so on, frequency, counters, and anything else. Here we have the consumption. It displays electricity energy consumption and power quality. It displays real-time waveforms, harmonics, trends, phasors. Also, we have the logs and reports. It displays event logs and diagnostics. And the last one, it's setup and diagnostics. It can help us to configure our Pro device, and it's help us for doing all the job with the SATEC PRO meter at the local level by using this very useful and interesting buttons and display. So here we can go to the setups, of course. And of course, we need to press some buttons for writing the passwords. And here we go. We go to the setup. Pro series device in this case is connected via the Ethernet port to a computer. The second Ethernet port is connected to the PM180 device. We will now the CIP addresses for each port. To do this, go to into the setup, enter the password. After that, we need to go to the communication setup and select the network one. Check if the address is compliant with your PC, and after that, go to the network two. Check the same, but this time for PM180. And we need to go to the switch mode. For correct pulling of the device from both Ethernet ports, we need to select daisy chain. Separated, it separates both interfaces. This mode is mainly used for transferring data to different systems. I'd like to pay your attention that the RS485 port of PM335 Pro, which is connected to EM133, is also used. In this case, the Pro will be the master and will essentially pull the EM133. Therefore, by connecting the multiple devices in series over this interface, we can simultaneously pull multiple devices using the PM335 as a master. Now you can see in more detail how the connection to the PM335 is made. PM180 via Ethernet port. The second port is connected to a PC. RS-485 is also used. In this case, PM335 is the master and the slave is EM133. The voltage circuits have also been connected to the Pro device by using a frequency converter. We can change the frequency and the voltages of the power grid. A 100 watt lamp is connected as a load. So now, as you can see, the load is changing and the voltage and frequency are changing on this display as well. Here we go, and now let's now see what this looks like in the vector diagram. Here we go, we can see the changes. Our lamp is here, and we can also see what the waveform looks like by voltage for each phase. Let's now look at what this looks like in pass. I have a demonstration in Russian, but I think you will get the hang of it. So we have the three sites, PM180, EM133 and of course Pro device. First of all, let's have a look at PM180 device configuration. The IP address of its Ethernet port is the same as the network as Ethernet port of the Pro. Therefore, we can query it without any problems. Now let's try to see the configuration of EM133. So here we set the IP address of Ethernet port connected to our PC, and of course we need to set the device address of EM133. In this case, we will also pull it without any problems. So it's very simple. Thank you for your attention. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to contact us. Have a nice day.